In this HitFilm Express tutorial for beginners, I will show you all the video editing skills you need to be able to make amazing videos. All of this in as little as just 17 minutes, no time wasted, pure content. This is Edward Stinga from Videoplasty, and let's get started. Alright, so when you open HitFilm Express, this is the home screen where you can see a lot of community updates, tutorials, and a lot of other cool things as well. Here on the left, you can buy some add-on packs because, you know, HitFilm Express is an amazing free software, but they still have to make money somehow. So click here where it says new to start a new project. Personally, I would suggest you leave everything else the same by default, but I would like to use the 1080p Full HD at 30 frames per second. That's my preferred preset. So click OK and let's start a new project. So here we are in the HitFilm Express video editing software. And at first, I understand the interface might look a little bit overwhelming, but just to give you a quick introduction, here on the top right, we have what is called a viewer. This is where we can preview our current edit and see how it looks like. Here on the left, we have what is called the trimmer, which is a very useful tool where you can have a look through the contents of a video or audio and add on the timeline just a small part that you want to use, not the full thing. Here on the bottom left, we have the media tab with a couple of other tabs that we're going to explore as well. It's basically where you import all the files in your project. Here in the middle, on the bottom half, we have what is called the editor, or also known as the timeline. This is where all the magic happens and all the editing happens. It has one video track here and one audio track. And you'll see later, we can actually add a lot of other tracks as well, depending on how complex our edit is. And last but not least, we have this thing right here called the meters, which is where we can monitor the audio and see how loud it is on the left channel and on the right channel. So I know that might look a bit confusing now when it's all empty, so let's just go ahead and import some media. You can go here and click import media, or what I personally like to do is I already have it selected in a separate folder and you just drag and drop it here. And that is my preferred method. So now if I click through those files that I have in the media tab, you can see I get a preview here on top. And let's go ahead and check out the trimmer, which is incredibly useful. So if I play back this video, as you can see, it starts from 0 seconds all the way to 39 seconds, which is a bit long. I don't really need that much in the video. So I'm going to pause it here. And you can use those two buttons to select what is called an endpoint over there at this specific point in time. And let's say we need the next couple of seconds, that should be enough. And we can select the endpoint or the out point here. And now when I drag and drop this here into the timeline, it's only going to be those 5 seconds from here to here. And compare that to dragging this here on the timeline as it is. This is 40 seconds and this here is just the 5 seconds that I need for this edit. So let's go ahead and select the other two videos, add them to the timeline and add the audio file as well. So as you can see, the video files are here with blue and the audio here with green to make sure you can differentiate the two of them. So now let's move to some basic editing here on the timeline. We have this thing right here called the playhead, which you can move around at different points on the timeline and it's going to preview the video and the audio. Alright, so at this point, our edit is pretty long here, all the way to 3 minutes, and we want the audio to be a tiny bit shorter. And the way to shorten clips or files that are on the timeline is by going to the end of the file. And as you can see, the cursor transforms into a bracket, and then you grab it and just move it like this all the way to here. But keep in mind, this is removing all this content and makes the whole thing shorter. But now I would say it's pretty small and it's hard to see what we're doing. So it's time to use this thing right here, which is called a timeline scale. You can either click those buttons to zoom in or just use the slider to control it yourself. And you can use this auto slider to go all the way on the timeline from the beginning to the end or whatever you are editing. But this is zoomed in enough so I can see much, much better what I'm doing. So it's time to arrange those auto clips and just keep everything pretty short. All right, so pretty much each video is around 5 seconds long now, and I'll make the audio around 15 seconds long. So if I go here on the beginning and click play, let's preview and see how that looks. Alright, you can also click play or pause here on the preview window by using this spacebar. It's actually an incredibly useful shortcut that I use all the time. So I noticed the audio is slow to start, so I want to remove this part right here, which is kind of silent. So I'll just trim the audio file like this, move it to the beginning, and then extend it at the end so it matches the video length. All right, now it's time to show you those tools right here. Actually, just a couple of them. Feel free to explore all of them later. So the first tool is the selection tool, which is the one I'm using. You can move things around and it's incredibly useful. Another really useful tool to have on is this thing on the bottom called the snapping. Is when you move things around without this snapping thing on, it just doesn't snap basically. But if you turn it back on, as you can see, maybe you want to move it all the way here. It snaps perfectly to the place where this one ends. Or maybe you want to move it all the way back, but perfectly here so it doesn't overlap the previous video. It's going to snap very easy. So I highly recommend you have that tool on. Next thing is the drag tool, which is a tool that you can just use to drag through the timeline to explore and see where you are. It's non-destructive. You cannot actually move anything with it. And the third one that I'll show you is actually incredibly useful. It's called a slice tool. And you can use this tool anywhere on a video or an audio file. And it's just going to slice it in two clips. So now instead of the one clip of the boat, we have two clips. And I can move this one around or delete it or do whatever I want. And there's a couple of other ones that I'm not going to show you, except for this one right here at the end, which is called the rate stretch tool. And it's incredibly interesting. So basically, for example, you have this video right here and you want to make it longer or shorter without destroying its actual content. It does that just by adjusting the speed. So for example, if I do this with the clip and make it double the length, it's actually going to be in slow motion now. So it starts at the same point and the end point. It doesn't actually destroy any of the content. It just literally doubled the speed. And you can do the same thing to speed up the whole thing. So now let's say it's going to play in double the speed and still show us the exact same content, just much faster. All right, my computer is a bit slow to preview that, but I think you get the point. So I'm just going to reset it to what it was initially. So a bit more basic editing here. On the audio file, you can see this white line that you can use to drag down to adjust the volume. So now it's pretty soft, we can't really hear anything, so I'll just move it all the way back. Yeah, should be alright, maybe a bit louder, but you know, play around with that. And you can do the exact same thing here on the video. It's a bit harder to see, but it still has this white line, which is basically controlling the opacity. And if you use the control button or command button on a Mac, you can actually insert what is called keyframes. So the keyframes, for example, control the value of the opacity at that particular point in time. So this way it kind of starts at zero opacity, goes all the way up to 100, then goes back down to zero. And we're going to look at keyframes a bit later because you can use it for other things, not just the opacity. Now I want to show you a new tab here called effects, and there are a lot of things that you can use here. Of course, we don't have time for all of them in this video, so feel free to explore. But I just want to show you a couple of easy ones, like for example, the fade. You can add a audio fade like this, and you can drag and drop it here in the beginning and do another one here at the end. You can adjust the length of the fade like this, and what this does is basically creates a nice fade in and fade out for the audio. And let's check it out. That's incredibly useful because if we didn't have this, it would just end up abruptly like this and sound kind of weird. Yeah, so definitely highly recommend that you use a fade for the audio. And also, if you don't want to do it manually like I just showed you previously, you can add a fade for the video as well. It's the exact same concept. Drag and drop it here at the end of the video and, you know, adjust the length. And now it has a fade on the video and the audio as well. Some other effects that you can use are, for example, transitions. If you scroll down here to video transitions, I'm going to show you a basic one, which is a cross dissolve. So you just drag and drop it here. And in this case, if it's a transition, you want to put it in between two videos. You don't want it to be just on this one or on this one. You want it in between those two. And let's see how it looks. I mean, of course, my computer lags right now because it's recording this tutorial as well, but I think you get the point. It's just a nice cross dissolve between this clip and this clip. Again, I suggest you explore this tab a bit more. There's a lot of other cool stuff that you can use, like blurs and some other nice effects. All right, so next I want to show you the controls tab, which is where you can change a lot of other values for the video or audio that you're editing right now. So here on transform, we have a lot of very useful ones, such as the position, move it right or left. You can also do that by just dragging it around in the preview area. Other things include the scale. You can make it larger or smaller, and you can also use this to rotate it. And of course, you can insert a direct value yourself like this, but we're just going to reset everything and go back to normal. And if you remember previously, I showed you that by holding the control key on a Windows or the command key on a Mac, you can add opacity keyframes here. And we have the opacity here on the controls tab. But what if we actually want to add keyframes for other things such as position or scale rather than just opacity? You can definitely do that as well, but you have to turn this on here. It's called a display timeline, so we can see it better. Make this a tiny bit larger. And let's keep those keyframes here for opacity. And as you can see, we have the exact same keyframes right now here on this tab. If you want to add keyframes for position, let's say here in the beginning, you have to click this button right here that enables or disables keyframes for that setting. So for position, let's say we wanted to start somewhere over here. Add a scale keyframe as well to make it a tiny bit smaller. And then as it moves forward in time, we want the scale to go to 100 and the image to move all the way here. Let's have a quick look. All right, so that's a basic introduction to keyframes. It's a pretty advanced concept if you've never seen it before, but it's basically controlling certain values and how they behave and change over time. And the basic ones are position, scale, rotation, opacity, but of course you can actually control keyframes for a lot of the effects as well, but that's pretty advanced and we're not gonna cover in this video. All right, so the last thing I wanna show you is how you can add text. And the way to do that is by using this tool right here with an A. And then you can drag a box here, for example. Or if you don't want to drag a box, you can just click anywhere here and just write Greece Holiday 2020 or whatever title you want to add to this. And this is going to create a new file here on another video track. And for all intents and purposes, it acts exactly the same as all the other videos. You can move it around, you can trim it down, make it longer, do whatever you want with it. If you want to actually edit the contents of the text, you need to go here where it says text. It's kind of hidden, so you can you have to click to get to it. And then you can select all the text here and change the text font, for example, to whatever you want to use, Open Sans, for example, make it bold, increase its size, do whatever you want with it. And of course, change the color as well if you want to do that. But I think it looks pretty all right. And here, if we go back to the select tool, you can just move it around somewhere else. And an important thing to understand in video editing is the order of the tracks here. Right now, the text is on top of the video tracks, so we can actually see the text on top of the video. But for example, if it was the other way around and we had this video on top, then this video covers the entire text file right here, so we don't see anything. But the text file is still there, because if we hide this track, it just reveals the text right there. However, this video just covers the whole thing, and that's how the order of the videos work on the video track. On the audio tracks, if you have multiple audio tracks, It's basically just gonna mix them. But for videos, that's how it works. The one that's on top has priority and that's the one you see. However, in this case, you see both of them because the text is just this, just text, and everything else is transparent. So it kind of reveals everything that's below it right here. So when it's all said and done, it's time to export the video. And before you do that, you got to figure out exactly how much of your timeline you want to export. And to do that is you right click here and just set to contents, for example. And this is going to export everything on the timeline up until the last asset here. You can also control this to export maybe a tiny bit less. For example, you might want to preview exactly this part right here in the middle. But in most cases, you probably want to export the whole thing. So right click here, set to contents. And now it's time to go here where it says view and click on export. So here on the export panel, we got a couple of things. We have our timeline that we just selected, and you got to click on this button where it says in, out, or contents. And in this case, we will use contents. It's basically the one that we just selected, or you can also use in, out, and it's going to export the entirety of the project length that you selected in project settings. I believe in our case, it was 5 minutes, but you don't want to do that. You never want to do that. So I'll just go with contents. And it just added a new task here in the queue. And I would suggest you use one of those presets. Of course, you can, if you know what you're doing, you can feel free to create your own preset with your own settings. But personally, I would go with YouTube 1080p. It does the job. It's a good preset. And here where it says output is basically where you want this to be exported and saved on your computer. I'll just leave it as it is by default. And when it's all ready to go, just click start exporting. All right, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and learned a lot of things. If you did, make sure to smash that like button and leave a comment to help with the YouTube algorithm. Make sure to subscribe to this channel as well for a lot more tutorials like this covering a lot of different software and a lot of video marketing content that's really good. So stay tuned. This was Edward Stinga from Videoplasty. Make sure to add me on Instagram as well, and I will see you in the next video.